Hello, in this video we'll be covering the process on how to print on our printers from C# using the TfhkaNet library. We'll be assuming that you already have your login account at the factory HKA. In case you don't have an account, go ahead and fill a registration form on our site, www.thefactoryhka.com. So now that you have your account, first you'll proceed to download the SDK for C#. To do this, simply go to our website at www.thefactoryhka.com/ve. Next, click on our utilities section. After that, proceed to log in with your username and password. After you've successfully logged in, proceed to enter our developer section. Once you're here, proceed to filter the SDK you're looking for. In this case, we'll select the SDK as a type of file and .NET as a type of technology. Once you apply this filter, you'll see the TfhkA SDK for .NET package ready for download. Once downloaded, you're ready to begin setting up the application to be able to print in our physical printers. After you've downloaded and decompressed your TfhkA SDK for .NET, you should see something like this. As you can see, in here you can find the application demo in the communication library with its respective manual. We'll be assuming that you already installed the .NET Framework 3.5 or newer in order to use the C# IDE. For this example, we'll be creating our demo from scratch. The first thing that you're going to do is opening the IDE of your choice. In this case, we'll be using Visual Studio 2013. Once in your IDE, proceed to click on the New Project link. After that, click on Visual C# in Windows. Then, select the Windows Forms application. Then, input the project name in the desktop's location and click OK. In this example, we'll be adding the minimum functions needed to be able to send a command to the printer. These functions would be open fpctrl for opening the communication port, close fpctrl for closing the communication port, and finally the sendcmd function to send the command. To prepare port managing interface, we're going to add a combo box for the port selection, a button for opening the port, and a button for closing the port. Add the COM ports list until COM 5 on the combo box 1. Also change the caption of button 1 and button 2 to open and close respectively. Add a text area which will be used to write the command we wish to send. And then add a button which we'll use to finally send the command. Take away the text from text box 1 and change the caption of button 3 to send. Our interface is now ready to be coded, but before we start the integration, we need to reference the library. Copy paste the library inside the project we just created. Once you have successfully pasted the TfhkaNet library, go to your project. Once in your project, right-click on it. Select Add, and then select Reference. Select the library from your project's folder and click OK. Once you have successfully referenced your library, then open your library manual and go to the importing and declaring section and copy-paste the function importing statements depending on the country that the integration is going to be implemented. In this case, we'll import tfhknet.if and tfhknet.if.ve. Once the importation is done, we'll declare and instantiate the object of the physical printer in our demo by putting the following code inside the class previously created. Now we're ready to start coding our demo. The majority of the functions are of type Boolean and always return a true or false, indicating the function was executed properly or not. It is important that we always save this value on a variable to have a better control in our system. We will call this variable answer. Declare the variable with the following line of code. Go to your design view to start coding the buttons of our demo. Double-click the open button to enter its coding section. In here, we'll add the line of code necessary to read the combo box's selected port and open it. Now go back to your design view and enter the close button's coding section. Add the following line of code to the button. After you've entered the coding section for the button, now let's code the send button. After you've entered the coding section for the button, add the following line of code. To finish, run your demo. Before selecting which port to open, make sure your printer is connected to the PC and turned on. To check what port the printer is communicating through, simply open your device manager and check in the ports section. As you can see here, the printer is connected to the COM4 port. Now select from the combo box the port where you have your printer connected. Then click the open button. At this point, you have opened the communication port. In this example, we'll be sending the command D to our printer. This will print out the printer's programming ticket. As you can see, after sending this command, the printer prints out the programming ticket. Feel free to test all the other functions and commands available to adapt the application to your needs.